Talking Mental Health on BCTV is sponsored by the County of Berks through the Berks County MHDD program in collaboration with the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center.
Hello, this is Jim Miller, and welcome to Talking Mental Health. Today we're going to be talking about Hope Springs Clubhouse. We did a show about 2 years ago when it was just becoming up and running. And so here we are 2 years later to see how Hope Springs Clubhouse is doing. My guests today are Alyssa Newmoyer. She is the manager of Clubhouse Services. By the way, this is a program through Threshold. Mm-hmm. And to her left is Johnny Rivera, and he's actually a member of the clubhouse, has been for about a year. And so welcome to both of you. Welcome to both of you. Let's just start out with telling us, Alyssa, what Hope Springs Clubhouse is. Clubhouse might be a word or a name that's not quite familiar. Mm-hmm. So they might think of Mickey Mouse Clubhouse or something. So this is different, right?
Yes, yes. Okay.
Tell us about Hope Springs.
And just to clarify, since you brought that up, a lot of folks think that we're a residential program as well, and that is not what we are. We don't do residential at the program. Mm-hmm. But we are a program for youth and young adults ages 16 to 25 mm-hmm. here in the county who are struggling with mental health barriers. We're there offering a site-based program mm-hmm. to help break down the barriers that those youth and young adults face. If you think about when you were a youth or young adult, mm-hmm. all of the turmoil that you probably went through, right, as a young person. So adding a mental health diagnosis on top of that is really a challenge. So we're there to kind of help bridge the gap between child-serving system and adult-serving system in mental health in order to kind of reduce that turmoil and stress on the young adults. We started with the Healthy Transitions Grant, which was a federal initiative through Now is the Time, which was there to help this age group. That's exactly what we're here doing.
Okay, well, very good. Talk to us about, the word clubhouse.
Yeah.
What it is about, what is the structure of it? I know what you refer to it as a model, a clubhouse model.
Yeah.
Tell me what that model is.
Okay, so we are focused on, it's called the work order day, to use clubhouse lingo. But that really just means that we are mirroring a normal workplace. So if you think of like a bank, how it's, usually like 8 to 5, 9 to 5. So we have those same type of hours for the clubhouse. And we're there to be productive. Mm-hmm. Both the staff, the members work together to achieve productive, meaningful work. Yeah. Okay. And also, the physical space itself, if you think about like a department store, picture Boscov's, where there's like men's shoes and women's clothing. Mm-hmm. It organizes both the employees, the people who work there, and also the people who are going to the store to receive the services, right?
Right.
So clubhouses have what we call work units. And so Hope Springs has the hospitality unit and the education and employment unit. So that structures, where our members work, if they have strengths in, social domains, or if they have strengths in understanding how to get into school or work, they can offer help to their peers by working in those two units.
Okay. I want to remind our viewers that you can call and ask questions of our guests. You can reach us at 610-378-0426. And so we'd love to hear from you. tell me how the model has been successful so far. Again, you're operating for about 2 years now, and you used the model. So how is it successful?
Okay, so I think with the young people that we're supporting, a lot of them are aging out of those child serving services.
Right.
We're helping to keep them wrapped in services during this transition. A lot of the young people, they fall off the grid. They
right.
get done with the child system, and they just fall out of services,
right.
Which leads to, a lot of chronic mental health barriers. They end up in the hospital a lot of times. So we're there to kind of be that safety net to keep them from ending up in the hospital. We're trying to transition them directly from those services into the adult services.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot of folks who are in school, who are in work, who are either who are already there or trying to go back into those realms. So we okay. offer two different programs, a supported education program and also a supported and transitional employment program. The supported education program is exactly what it sounds like. We support folks in either returning to school settings or, staying in them. So if folks are in high school, we can go to IEP meetings, which we've done, and it's
okay.
really supported the folks in those. They invite us to them, and we're able to kind of work as a team rather than just being this random service floating around. We're allowed... we're really able to collaborate with the other services currently in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with college. We can go meet on campus, talk with advisors, really help collaborate as far as, what their goal is, and really work with the folks who are directly supporting them in that. So,
yeah.
We're just offering a little extra support.
Let's talk about specific goals or the current goals of your membership.
Okay. So currently we have, like I said about school, we've got folks who are trying to stay in school or go back to school. We have folks who have come to the clubhouse and want to get jobs, just like any young person. Those are usually the two main focuses.
Okay.
But a lot of folks with mental health barriers, they're also struggling with, social aspect, whether that's because they've been bullied in school or... some of their symptoms have really caused issues with their family. So we're there to help with both of those. We can help, with our site, we can help them create friendships, healthy friendships at the clubhouse mm-hmm. that they can carry out into their lives, evenings and weekends. And then we can also support them in finding housing if they need that. If that's what can help them in, really re-strengthening and reconnecting with family is to kind of get out of the house or, if... that's already crossed that limit and they've kind of been cut off. We can help them, go out into the community.
So almost anything that will help them succeed.
Yes. Yeah. Any kind of goal that they have for themselves, we're there to help.
Okay.
Yeah. And if we can't, we'll find someone who can.
Okay.
Yeah. Resources and skills. That's what we're all about.
Okay. Johnny, what Alyssa was talking about, the types of goals that people have, different people have, but I'd like to hear from you and talk about the goals that you have. Now, you've been there, as I said, almost a year. So what are the things that that you're working on?
Well, I'm working on making new friends, positive friendships,
okay.
and getting my license and hopefully open a restaurant because I'm a chef and a cook at Clown Plaza.
Okay. So... you get basically three goals that you're working on while you're there.
Right.
So tell me what it's like there on a daily basis. You go there every day, you told me, from about what time to what time?
Until 8 to 3.
Okay. So what's your typical day? What happens?
Routine is to make breakfast for staff and members. We do tasks. We do... unit meetings and mm-hmm. we do wellness walks and I help the members with their task and I also help the staff with their some paperwork that they need help with.
Okay. All right. I'm sure a lot of us that people are watching don't know. What happens at a unit meeting? What does that mean?
And unit meeting, like, we get all the members together, mm-hmm. and we discuss with the task we have to do on a computer. So basically, if I do, like, your chosen voice, and you have to, you can literally pick your own, your chosen voice, or okay. 10 history, it has to be, like, today, like, the today's date, or current event is basically what happened in Reading, and community events, like, happen around Reading.
Right.
And then your the jokes is like basically you can search it up or you can make your own jokes. And the meeting of the day, it has to be something appropriate for the members or the staff can approve to it.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
So Johnny's discussing like our daily news bulletin.
Yes.
That's one of the things that we work on in unit meetings, right?
Right.
And he also mentioned about tasks. So that's kind of like this weird word that we all throw around, but you know, unless you're part of Clubhouse, you probably don't really understand what we're talking about. So we, you know, we really have our members take ownership of the program. Mm-hmm. And that means that they help us take care of it and run it. So, you know, Johnny's here with me right now,
right.
which is probably not a traditional thing as far right. as mental but, health services.
But it is a task.
Yeah, yep, exactly. That, he's talking about paperwork, which they're involved mm-hmm. in every part of that. You know, getting involved in, you know, physically cleaning the clubhouse, doing tours, all of those things our membership really helps out with.
Yeah. Before the show, Johnny was sharing with me, you know, going there for the first time and how he's basically a shy person. And it's one of the things that he needed to address to move forward in his life.
Mm-hmm.
And go from a shy person to a person on a TV show. That's a pretty big transition.
Yeah, yeah.
You're doing very well, Johnny. Now, I understand there's social and holiday events that take place, and can you explain what those kind of things are?
So basically, the socials and holidays, we go to the staff to plan the holidays like Halloween mm-hmm. or potlucks or the socials like Crystal Cave, Green Dragon or golfing. We go to them and then we just basically ask them what we want to do. Mm-hmm. So the potluck is like we do for to bring like food for the potluck and have fun, yeah. like play games. And Halloween, we just like decorate the clubhouse for holidays.
So whatever the holiday is.
Yeah.
Okay. You gonna do something for Thanksgiving or Christmas? Any plans at the clubhouse?
Yeah,
we're working on it.
Okay.
Yeah, we actually have a house meeting next week that we'll be ironing out all the details about Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. Yep.
And what did Alyssa wear for Halloween? What was her costume? I don't know if you know that.
Yeah,
do you remember?
Yeah, she had like a jam shirt that she made for herself.
Okay.
It's like a jam, like mm-hmm. some fruit, and then she put like on her side like jam it. So I just said something to Alyssa like
from Parks and Rec.
I just told Alyssa like to jam it, like to do something funny. So everybody had a good time at the Halloween party. We played games. We also had a good time, take pictures, had a Halloween country contest, and.
Good.
After that, we all cleaned up.
What was your costume?
my costume was a Teen Wolf character.
Okay.
So basically, I had to make everything, like the nails and the fangs. I had to prep that before I came to the clubhouse.
Yeah.
And then I had like wear outfit for me, like red and blue pants, and then I had like regular shoes on.
Yeah. That's great. I'm glad to hear that. So besides doing tasks, it can be fun.
Yeah, of course.
And it sounds like the socialization aspect of it is really important.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing I like about Clubhouse and Johnny, you using the term you're a member, means that you belong to something, right?
Right.
That you're part of something. And lots of times folks can be alienated and they don't feel part of something or they don't feel like a member of something. So this is a great idea. Now, Alyssa, again, we were here about 2 years ago when this was starting up. Have things changed at all in the 2 years? You had your goal, you knew what you were working for. So what has happened in those 2 years?
Well, we opened up with four members.
Okay.
So we've grown quite a bit. We've transitioned from four up to currently about 26, 27 active members. And active meaning that they're currently receiving services from us.
Right.
Throughout our lifetime, we've served about probably 75, somewhere around there. So we've really gotten quite a bit bigger. And recently we've kind of hit this threshold of daily attenders where, it's really feeling like a clubhouse.
Mm-hmm.
We've got folks who are there every day who are really, taking ownership of the clubhouse,
yeah.
Proud of it, putting work into it, really turning it into something bigger than just, mm-hmm. just a space. They all come, they work together. We have all sorts of meetings and events that we all participate in. We all have a good time. We're part of a community, so it's really exciting.
I just like the part where the members are driving it. The members are coming to staff and saying, "Hey, this is what we want to do," instead of the staff going to them saying, "This is what you have to do."
Exactly. Yep.
And that's really great. It's really great to hear. Again, for our viewers, you can call us at 610-378-0428 if you have questions for our guests. Again, to remind you, our guests are Alyssa Newmoyer. She's the manager of Clubhouse Services at Hope Springs. And we have Johnny Rivera. He's a member. How can our viewers learn more? This is a basically a half-hour show. We certainly can't cover everything.
Yeah.
So how can people get a hold of you?
Okay.
And learn more?
Well, they can call into the clubhouse. Our phone number is 484-650-0198.
Mm-hmm.
And members are usually the ones answering the phone. So if you've got questions for members, call us up. Let them know. Anyone is always happy to answer any questions you might have. Whether that's for yourself, a family member, someone you're supporting, just really we're open for calls. Also, you can always stop by for a tour. If you're in the area and you want to stop in, please do. You don't need to call ahead of time. It's appreciated. But if you find yourself in the area and, you really want to reach out, please do. Members like Johnny are always there, willing to give tours, excited to give tours. That's okay. It's okay to just stop in. That's what we're there for. We're there as a community we're there to open people with open mm-hmm. arms.
You want to tell us where the location is? I don't know. Did we do that?
We didn't do that.
Okay.
Yeah, you're right.
All right.
If anyone's familiar with the SAM building in Reading, our actual address is 19 North 6th Street, which is where the SAM building is located. But we're on the first floor. It's right across from the courthouse, pretty central Reading.
So basically 6th and Court mm-hmm. is the cross street.
Yes. Yep.
Yes. Okay.
Yep. You can also visit the Pennsylvania Clubhouse Coalition website, as well as Threshold Rehabilitation Services website. The Coalition, we are part of a larger group of clubhouses across the state. So please feel free to jump on if you're not in our area. There's clubhouses all around. And then for Threshold, just check under behavioral health and we'll be listed and check out our page.
All right. So do members or staff get to meet with and interact with other clubhouses, people from other clubhouses?
Yes. Yep. The Coalition, that's the whole point of it. We're there mm-hmm. to support each other. We have conference calls, we've got board meetings that we go to a few times a year, and there's a large conference in the spring every year as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Alyssa kind of offered your services as giving tours, right?
Yes.
So you wanted the people to do that. So what could someone expect when they got a tour of the, what would happen in a tour? as you would give?
So basically, when I give a tour, I just go from the top to bottom. Like, I go to the unit meeting, the CAF, and the kitchen. Okay. And then if they have, like, any question from the top unit meeting, they can feel free to ask me, or they can wait until when I finish the tour. And then I show them downstairs, downstairs unit meeting.
Okay.
And then I just explain to them the computers, the closet, and then the other unit meeting that we have.
Okay. Alyssa, anything else? If you're giving a tour, what do you do?
Yeah, so John is leaving out all the fun stuff. He also points out, you know, what do we do in those big areas of the clubhouse? You know, he always is sure to point on all the socials we do, what kinds of events we do as he's touring through. Mm-hmm. And then, depending on who gives it, whether it's myself, you'll just continue talking to me, or if Johnny or another member gives a tour, mm-hmm. you'll meet with one of the staff and meet to complete some paperwork to help us obtain the rest of the paperwork that's needed to become a member, and answer any questions that the member was unable to answer.
So let's say somebody's watching this show and they think they would like to be a member of the clubhouse. What's required? What needs to happen for someone to get in officially as a member of the clubhouse?
Okay. So they need to come for a tour. You don't need any paperwork to come for a tour. You can stop in, like I said, anytime.
Okay.
And then we need a few forms and a psychiatric evaluation. The first form is our referral form. This is a form that can be completed by the person interested, and, you know, or with themselves and someone who's supporting them. And then the recommendation form needs to be signed by an LPHA, which is a licensed practitioner of the healing arts, which would include anyone who can diagnose would be able to sign off on that.
Okay.
And then once we receive that, they would come for an intake.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if they come for an intake, let's say they've gotten through all that, they've had the form signed by who they need to have it signed. So they come in for an intake. So, you know, Johnny was saying that, you know, he was very nervous the first day he came in. And, you know, I assume that he had to have an intake. So what happens at the intake?
So we have a conversation, kind of relax any nervousness that's going on. Talk about the individual's goals. You know, what do they want to work on? And, you know, a lot of times folks come with parents or supports that they already have, and we've got to make sure that we're focusing on what the member wants.
Mm-hmm.
So we focus in on, you know, what do you want to work on when you're here? So we have that conversation. We figure out how, not only what they want to work on, but how can we support them? What can we offer and allow them to get kind of an idea of what's going to happen when they become a member?
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, the documentation that everyone just loves.
Yes, yes.
Get some signatures. Yep.
Okay. But that whole intake and everything, Johnny, was worth it, right? To go through all that to get what you have now, right?
It's worth it.
Yeah. And again, maybe a little nerve-wracking or making you nervous, but it's worth it. I guess you can't go anywhere anymore where there's not, you know, you go to a new doctor, you go here, you go there. It seems like there's always an intake.
I know. There's always forms to sign.
Yes, yes. We talked about the age. I think the age of clubhouse members is 16 to 26.
To 25, yeah.
To 25.
Yep.
So that means that... And I haven't asked you, Johnny, how old you are. You don't have to tell me. But so what happens if Johnny's involved in the clubhouse and he turns 26? What happens?
So we have a partner clubhouse, which some folks might be familiar with because they've been around since the 90s. The clubhouse is called Mosaic House, and they serve 18 and older, though they are focused on like an older population. So when our folks age out of our program, we have created a transition process from our program to Mosaic House, which includes 2 months before that member's birthday, their 26th birthday, we start figuring out all the paperwork, everything that might be needed to get them to become an active member at Mosaic House.
Yeah.
And then a month before, hopefully at that point we've already gotten the paperwork, you know, we do a discharge from Hope Springs and an intake at Mosaic House. But what's beautiful about the clubhouse model is that once you're a member, you're always a member. You're always allowed back.
Okay.
So they, you know, they're allowed to come and attend both clubhouses during this transition process. Okay. And that way folks can, you know, kind of continue receiving support from those they're familiar with and comfortable with while they begin to warm up to their new staff, the new faces that they're going to see every day, the new membership at Mosaic House. And then, you know, by probably about a month after their 26th birthday, they're expected to start going to Mosaic House regularly. They're always allowed to come back and visit us, mm-hmm. You know, but Mosaic House becomes their primary clubhouse.
Okay.
Yeah.
Getting back to Hope Springs, and, you know, we have you here, Johnny, because you're a member and you know what it's like to be a member. Can you give the young viewers who are thinking about this a tip or a piece of advice if they're thinking about becoming a member? What would you say to them?
Well, I would say to them is to take a deep breath, and when they take a deep breath, they will come out of their shell. And then, like I said before, that they want to not talk to them because they get shy like mm-hmm. I was, yeah. But when they get used to that, then they can go up to them and talk to them.
Okay, very good advice. Today my guests have been Alyssa Newmoyer, she's a manager of Hope Springs Clubhouse. Johnny Rivera is a member, and we thank you for being here.
Of course.
I intend to get down there and get one of those famous tours. Thank you.
We'd love to have you. Thank you.
This is Jim Miller from Talking Mental Health. We'll see you next time.
Talking Mental Health on BCTV is sponsored by the County of Berks through the Berks County MHDD program in collaboration with the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center.